you know, when you're famous and you can't go back.
Britney's life was never the same. After childhood fame led her to a complete breakdown, this pop icon's life took a complete turn for the worst. 2007 was not Britney's year. Since then, Brit's career has flourished with a growing empire of music, tours, and brands, but the star is not without her share of struggles.
But it's like I'm having to pay for it for a really long time.
What looks like a life of glamorous fame and fortune is not what it seems. Among other celebs such as Justin Timberlake, Christina Aguilera, and Ryan Gosling, Britney was a member of the Mickey Mouse Club on the Disney Channel and mastered the skills of performance from a young age. The star soon launched a solo pop brand with her debut hit, Hit Me Baby One More Time, which sold over 25 million copies. With a successful album, a sweetheart romance to boy band frontman JT, and a few more hits, Britney's career flourished and she graced the covers of endless teen magazines. She starred in a feature film titled Crossroads that received negative reviews, but was a box office hit thanks to Brit's army of fans. In her early 20s, things started to go downhill. After her breakup from the NSYNC star, the pop princess had a fleeting marriage, we're talking less than a week, to childhood friend Jason Alexander. She then quickly wed backup dancer Kevin Federline, and the couple had two sons, Sean and Jaden. The young mother's instability began to worry her family. Britney's maternal abilities were already being questioned when her son was 4 months old. Brit was photographed driving with her infant child on her lap, sans car seat or belt. She later released a statement saying that she was fleeing aggressive paparazzi and feared for the safety of her child. I was terrified that this time the physically aggressive paparazzi would put both me and my baby in danger. I instinctively took measures to get my baby and me out of harm's way, but the paparazzi continued to stalk us, she said. I love my child and would do anything to protect him, but the press didn't let it go and continued to follow the star's every move. By 2007, when Britney was almost 25, she divorced Kevin and entered into a messy custody battle. The pressures of the constant media coverage became too much to handle. The star made a visit to a rehab facility in the Caribbean called Crossroads Center. When Britney's inevitable total breakdown took place, the event was highly publicized, and the whole world watched as the star, in February of 2007, in Sherman Oaks, California, spontaneously shaved her own head at a salon.
I said, "What's up? Can I help you?" She said, "I want to shave my hair off."
After the stylist refused to, Brit grabbed the clippers and mowed down her locks, extensions and all. The bald Britney then also attacked a paparazzi photographer who had been harassing her for a photo with an umbrella. Unfortunately, once the bad press started, it kept rolling in. Despite the difficulties Britney was facing, she assured fans with a post on her website promising a comeback. "I know I've been far from perfect, and the media has had a lot of fun exaggerating my every move. I look forward to coming back this year, bigger and better than ever." 2 days after the umbrella incident, Britney checked herself into a rehab facility in Malibu called Promises. In a later post to her website, Britney told fans of her dark time. "I genuinely did not know what to do with myself, and it made me so sad. I confess I was so lost." In the summer of 2007, Britney's divorce from K-Fed was finalized, and she lost custody of her two boys due to her issues with mental health and the law. In September, Britney performed at the MTV Music Awards in a too-soon attempted comeback, but the show was considered a disastrous flop and fans became worried about the star. But Brit quickly found her way back to the top professionally with her November 2007 release of an album called Blackout that hit number 2 on the Billboard charts. By the end of the year, her career carried on as if nothing was wrong, with her Piece of Me track winning multiple awards, including Video of the Year. Fans saw the much-hoped-for comeback of America's pop princess.
"I'm just progressively but slowly getting it together."
But despite her outward successes, Britney was still dealing with mental health issues and the strain of a custody battle with her ex. In early 2008, the star was placed under a legal conservatorship, a type of guardianship which gave her father complete control of both her career and personal life. Britney was granted 30% custody of her sons, but was also paying a $200,000 monthly payment in child support to Kevin. 7. Her father, Jamie, was given control of everything in Britt's life, from her bank account and her monthly allowance to decisions about her music and tours. He also took a salary from his daughter's income. As part of the conservatorship, Brittany isn't legally allowed many basic rights, such as getting married, driving, having children, voting, or having knowledge of how her money is being spent.
No, I don't feel like it's out of control. I think it's too in control.
She isn't even allowed to give unscripted interviews or to leave her property unsupervised. Jamie is in control of the star's assets and estate as well, including her Beverly Hills home. Her conservatorship can restrict Britt from traveling, seeing friends, and even from posting online or using the internet unmonitored. She also isn't allowed to hire her own lawyer. The singer also can't participate in any negotiations regarding her business or brand. Britt isn't allowed to discuss the legal rules, but with fans digging into the story and claiming the unjustness, the constraints have come to light. Jamie was the sole person overseeing Britney's finances until he was hospitalized for an illness in early 2019. But in 2020, some fans were amazed to hear that all of this was still going on. The guardianship, after all, was meant to be temporary. 38-year-old Britney Spears, with a solid career, two teenage children, and an ever-bubbly personality, has never been able to remove herself from the legal thumb of her conservatorship. This is surprising because of the incredible career Britney has built over the last 12 years. Since the conservatorship began, the Spears empire has grown tenfold. Along with her lucrative music production, she's been a judge on The X Factor, has released multiple fragrances, created a clothing line, not to mention that she has done multiple successful world tours. Her Piece of Me tour in 2018 also earned the star $54.6 million and was a huge success. Now that Britney's net worth is estimated at approximately $59 million, fans are questioning why the seemingly stable star still does not have any control over her own life or finances. She's the one putting in the work. Although the agreement was put in place to protect the star from her own instability at the time, fans are now wondering how much guardianship the star actually needs. 2020 sparked a renewed concern for the status of Britney's conservatorship and well-being. Her conservatorship was extended until late August, and the star would be required to appear in court to fight for her freedom. The star has many devoted fans who noticed her worrisome posts on social media. They worried she was being controlled and manipulated. Early in the year, Britney's upcoming Vegas residency was canceled, citing reasons as issues with the singer's medications. At the same time, Britney's father, Jamie, was also facing his own medical issues with a diagnosis and hospitalization that prevented him from acting as guardian to his daughter's career. She has also stopped touring and producing new music. Concern for the singer sparked the hashtag Free Britney movement. The singer appears to be living a happy life despite the constraints. She has been dating her boyfriend, personal trainer Sam Asghari, since late 2016. Fans scouring her social media encouraged the star to reach out for help if she needed it. The Free Britney movement even asked the singer to wear yellow to send a covert message on Instagram. Seeing as Britney recently posted about her favorite color, yellow, being a symbol of positivity, fans are more concerned than ever. Is it an overreaction? Britney herself shared on Instagram, "Don't believe everything you read." Britney's brother, Brian Spears, recently spoke out on the issue. Harper's Bazaar reports that he said of the conservatorship, "She's been in this thing for quite some time now. Obviously, there was a need for it in the beginning. Now, they've made some changes, and all we can do is hope for the best." Brian also defended his father's decisions on the matter. "Our father has done the best he could, given the situation he was put in. We've had to work together as a family." The Free Britney movement advocates believe otherwise. It seems to some that Britney's family does not have her best interest at heart. Every time Britney shares a post on social media, comments are flooded with, "Are you okay?" Later this summer, Britney will need to enter into a legal court battle to regain her autonomy. Conservatorships of her type, a lawyer told Business Insider, are unusual for someone as young and productive as Spears. In 2019, after Britney allegedly attempted to have some of the restrictions eased up, asking a judge to consider lifting the guardianship, she was refused. Jamie, instead, had the legal guardianship extended to more states, including Hawaii and Florida. According to Business Insider, Jamie was still profiting from the arrangement during Britt's musical hiatus, taking $128,000 in 2019, along with the $1.1 million that Britt has spent on the conservatorship agreement fees that year alone. Recently, however, the Free Britney movement unintentionally caused more harm than good for the star. Her upcoming hearing had to be postponed after a confidential Zoom call was infiltrated by concerned hacking fans. The hearing, which was scheduled for August, will now be pushed back. Because of the delay, Britney will unfortunately have no chance in being able to vote in the upcoming presidential election. Britt has also expressed her desire to potentially have a child or get married to her longtime boyfriend Asghari. Under her current situation, neither are allowed without her father's permission. Is all of this a bit too much as a response to events that occurred all the way back in 2007? Britney has always dealt with the legal constraints and hardships with a smile on her face. A scroll through the star's social media is like a breath of positivity, both with her upbeat posts and the heartfelt comments from devoted fans. No matter what happens, Britney's fans are definitely on her side. Do you think that Britney's breakdown changed her life forever? Is it time to let her finally move on? Let us know what you think in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to The Taco for more videos about your favorite celebs. Bye for now.